feet in New Orleans. Big Snoop Dogg got a Madden league. His team is off the hook and you don't really want none. But if you do, come and get some. See, tell your mama and tell your daddy and tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy.
Kamara Drive-In. Hello, everyone. I'm Jonathan Coachman. This is Madden NFL Football on EA Sports. Coming up, 2017 Offensive Rookie of the Year, Alvin Kamara. Fresh off a big performance a week ago, as it'll be the New Orleans Saints taking on the Dallas Cowboys.
Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New Orleans Saints and the Dallas Cowboys. Hello again, everyone. I'm Brandon Gunn, joined as always by Charles Davis. And Charles, you take a look at this Cowboy team entering play. They come in playing some decent football, 5-3 in their last eight games. Meanwhile, for the visiting Saints, they're halfway home, looking good at a perfect 8-0.
And not much to complain about so far, is there? I'd have to say they're the best team in the NFL through the first half of the year.
Kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And here come the Saints for their opening drive. And a glance at the tall signal caller, standing 6'6".
What I enjoyed this week is that you asked to talk to his offensive center before the game and find out a little bit more about him and what the relationship is. And that was a pretty positive story, wasn't it?
Yeah, and really what I took away from that is just how it has permeated throughout the entire offensive line, the relationship they've had. It's really a group that's in sync.
They care about him.
Marcus Lawrence in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year.
Well, the pass rush has been a real strength of late. They know how to get after the quarterback.
Absolutely. 4 sacks last week. That's their first one here. Anything in particular you've seen from them or on film?
I think that they're winning athletically up front, winning those one-on-one battles. But also, when the offensive line wants to keep everyone in and mass protect, they know how to scheme their way back to the quarterback as well.
Here's Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down. This will be fielded at the 17. A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. So here are the Cowboys under head coach Jason Garrett as they get set for their first opportunity. As we get a peek at their dynamic signal caller hailing from Mississippi State, it's Dak Prescott. So first and 10 now from the 30. They'll begin here with Bernard. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. And now it looks like we've got a Cowboy shaking up down there on the field. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he'll get to the 29-yard line. Brought down there. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. And on this offensive unit, your thoughts on Travis Frederick?
He's a quarterback's best friend. Sets all the line calls and blocks so aggressively.
Hey, man. Watch the boot. open.
On third down, it's Prescott. Space to maneuver at the 40. Over the middle into traffic, and that's complete.
Let's go! Let's go!
14 yards, good for a Cowboy first down.
Partners, a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
On first down, it's Sharp. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. A look now at the defensive starters for the Saints. They were very good in the win last week against Jacksonville.
And what I saw on film was nearly an unstoppable pass rush. They had five sacks last week, plenty of hurries. So now do you just max protect on offense, keep everyone in and run, you know, one or two receiver routes to make sure your quarterback stays up? We'll soon find out.
To throw on second and six. Prescott got an open man. It's Michael Gallup. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints' 41-yard line. For Gallup, a check on the numbers from a week ago. Four catches, 57 yards.
And what we just saw there was exactly what they need against this defense. Big plays. They were able to pick up a first down on that one.
On first and 10, Prescott. Gonna be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Tack McKinley made his way into the backfield. You know darn well both of these teams reviewed the film and saw that this defense had five sacks last week. They got to keep their QB upright.
And they're going to try their best to do exactly that. But they're facing a team where getting to the quarterback is a mindset. It's a mantra for them. And they play a game within the game. And you know what it is? Let's race to the quarterback and see who gets there first.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Prescott to throw it. And his throw here is incomplete. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Off the play fake, Prescott. Open man, there is Patterson, complete. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 28.
Press coverage on the outside, and for defenders, that's the ultimate risk reward. If you take the risk, can you reward yourself by keeping them on the line of scrimmage? But no, not on that one. Got the step on him. Now it's just a matter of laying the ball out there for him to go get it.
They'll run on first down. Sharp down to the 25. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. From the 25 on second down, Prescott. His throw caught right around the six. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the five-yard line. A good pickup there, 21 yards. Well, they're piecing together a nice drive to start this one. Seems pretty scripted and pretty successful so far.
And I think they did it without our help. Because you remember when we sat in the production meeting with them to talk about this and, hey, you know, how you guys going to come out of the gate? I know I offered my help with a few plays, and they didn't seem to want it.
I didn't offer mine.
You were the smart one. Whatever they're doing, though.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. It's the linebacker, Alex Anzalone.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went three and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys are a little bit jumpy.
You do.
Oh, you understand the same way. Just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went three and out.
And now they have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go three and out. I went three and out on that first drive. I'm trying to do better here. Here's Shaw. And Thomas has it. It'll be a Saints first down on a gain of 16 yards.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And 3 yards there takes him to the 45. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
Stay with your man. Check three, check three.
They stay on the ground. This time it's Kamara. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a yard, and they're going to face a third down. It's no secret that this is a team that's built on passing, but as you always tell me, you have to throw the run in there every now and then to keep that pass sharp.
Yeah, you have to, because otherwise, if they never have to worry about running the football, it is just a controlled sprint to your quarterback. And eventually, you're calling on your backup quarterback.
But they got to do better than that last go-around. They went in the wrong direction. Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zapped right back in the other direction.
Come on, baby. Let's go!
And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And, you know, certainly a lot of football left to be played. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're first place in their division, looking good, looking to be a threat come January.
And let's think about what every team has in their goals, all right? Number one goal is what? Make the playoffs. Number two goal is win your division. Number three goal, and the biggest goal, I think, is to be the highest seed possible that you can be heading into the playoffs so that you can have as many home games as possible to try and get you to the Super Bowl.
And right now, fighting for every win possible to try to at least secure home field for the wild card and or divisional round. A 3 yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's taken down. It's a gain of 3 from the 17 to the 20.
He's brought down at the 20 yard line. It's a gain of 3.
Play action now. Prescott is going to float this one deep right. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete.
To figure they take a shot downfield on third and long, so the old cliche came into mind right away for me. Who wants it more? You always hear about receivers, you hear about their hands, their moves, their speed. How about the positioning and the desire to go get that one out of the air?
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10.
I'm coming after you.
Here's Prescott. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. He'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. A gain of 6 there on first.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Looking to throw, Prescott. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end.
Yeah, baby.
That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
47
on third down, Sharp. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
They had yet to run the ball at all on this drive, but third and short, definitely was a great time to dial one up.
first carry for their fullback. Powers through. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
Well, he tried to bounce it outside, but that's obviously not his game. He's too much of a straight line runner.
Yeah, him in the outer third of the field, not a recipe for success. That time a loss. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11.
Hey, we are.
Flanagan.
Mike's 47. Let's go.
They'll run it here. This is their fullback getting the carry. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. The second down play, not much better than the first. Just a gain of one there. Prescott from the gun on third. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. Back of the end zone, could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
That's a good job there creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now since it's fourth down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to three. So on fourth down, Jason Garrett sends in his field goal unit. They'll spot it at the 30, so this is a 40-yard attempt. And his kick is good. And the Cowboys are going to jump out to a 3-0 lead. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive gets them 3, not 6.
Is it okay if I give credit to both sides on this one?
Absolutely.
All right, let's start defensively. They hung in there. 10-play drive. But they stiffened when they got close to the goal line, made them kick a field goal. For the offense, 10-play drive. They might be a little disappointed they got a field goal, but they moved the ball down the field with dispatch and came away with points.
And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Looking to throw. Shaw. And a quick throw here. That's complete.
That's it, baby. That's up, baby.
And the Cowboys here on third down bringing in an extra defensive back. From the gun, Shaw. The open man is Smith. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. A good pickup there, a 22. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
Now a play fake here on first down. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The target that time, Michael Thomas. And that'll bring up second down. Time for a look at our starters here on defense. It's quite a unit. Number one in the NFL against the pass.
Yeah, defending the pass hasn't been an issue for them. It's been stopping the run. And if they don't stop the run, they can't get back to their strength, which is guarding against the air attack.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Here's Kamara off the draw. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. A 6-yard pickup on the ground that time, and that'll make it 3rd and 4 coming up. From the gun on 3rd down, Shaw. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. They have the 1st down with that gain of 4 yards. Nothing after 1 on EA Sports. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. On the ground, this is Kamara. DeMarcus Lawrence in on the tackle. They'll run it now out of the gun. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. The tally there, -2 yards, brings up 3rd down.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
The Saints on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. Operating from the gun, Shaw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. 10 yards, good for a Saints 1st down.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the 1st down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
Yeah, they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. So 1st and 10 now from the 30. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And he's got about 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 25. Looking to throw on 2nd down. Shaw out of the backfield. That's complete to Kamara. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. It'll wind up being a loss of 2. And that's going to lead to a 3rd down. A pass for negative yardage, obviously no good. Maybe he shouldn't have thrown it, or maybe he shouldn't have caught it.
I think we were seeing it at the same time, weren't we? Maybe you let that one go, right? Because you can see the lost yardage about to develop. But that goes against every instinct of a receiver. They're taught to catch everything. So it's really hard to be mad at him and yell at him for trying to make that play.
Back to throw. Shaw, he's got his man. It's Andrews. First catch so far for the man who led the NFL coming into the weekend. He's got a 1st down.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from you a little bit, and that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
A 1st opportunity upcoming in the red zone for the Saints. They've got a 1st and 10 at the 17. From the gun, Shaw. Throw left side, complete. That's Flynn. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. The completion good for 3, and it's 2nd down. Here's a 2nd and 7. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14.
We'll put that one in the win column for the defense. Trying to contain tight ends in the passing game is so difficult nowadays, but they did in a big way there.
The Saints on 3rd down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This is 3rd and 7. Looking to throw. Shaw. This will be caught at about the 6. 70th catch for him on the year. And like so many others, this goes for a 1st down. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
So another third down conversion, and now they've got a first and goal. Back to throw, Shaw, and down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. Yannick Ngakoue, able to record his fifth sack of the season.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. It's second and goal, but now all the way back at the 14. Second and 14. This will be caught at about the 6. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. They'll wind up getting 7 on the completion, but they'll still be faced now with a third and goal situation. And it's caught. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. They wind up with 6 on the hook up there, but it's not enough. Fourth and goal.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
And Lutz's kick is good. And that will tie us at 3-3. So three drives now for this offense, and that field goal gives them their first 3 points.
So if you're an offensive coordinator and you're averaging a point a drive, you're in the wrong lot of work, aren't you? You got to find a way to unlock the key to these defenses and put some big points on the board.
Field goal's all we've had so far. 3-3 now as the kick is away. This is taken at his 4. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And now here come the Cowboys. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted them, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it. I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
To throw again on second down, Prescott, Cameron Jordan. He's the culprit, and that is now his 13th sack of the season as his great year continues. He was trying to keep his eyes downfield. Nobody came open.
He's trying to do everything that he had been taught, right? Every bit of the technique. But if no one's open, there is no technique except make sure you hold on to the ball as you go to the ground when you're getting sacked.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Prescott from the gun. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And this play going to be stopped in its tracks at the 32 and obviously well short of the first down. It'll be a pickup of 13, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Here again comes the captain of this offense, leading his crew back out there now. And maybe he's starting to wave the white flag a little bit. He's playing pretty well, but the pressure, it's got to him.
Has to find a way to step around it, step through it, or just handle it. Because as you mentioned, he's having a pretty good day overall. just the hits keep coming and taking those sacks. That's not the way that they want to finish a ball game with their quarterback on the ground so much.
And he'd like to stay upright. When he's been upright, he's been pretty good. Operating from the 27 now. Here's second and three. Off play action. Shaw under a heavy rush and down he goes.
Tremendous read and reaction by the defensive tackle and friendly partner. It's not that often the DTs have that type of easy access back to the quarterback. Never bought the play action fade.
The Saints on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This is third and 10. Looking to throw. Shaw looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. The Saints first down there on a gain of 11.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
This quarterback now, 15 out of 17 through the air, only 2 incompletions. It's first down. Operating from the gun, Shaw. This is complete to Michael Thomas. A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Second and 4. A short throw caught by Andrews. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41. The offense on third down tonight, 6 conversions and 9 tries. They've done a great job of picking these up. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
So after the run by Kamara, now another first and 10. From the gun, Shaw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. That throw good for 4. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because really they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
Here's Thomas Morstead now as he's on to punt for New Orleans. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And it's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
They go over the middle, and it's complete to start the drive. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. Now a handoff here to his running back. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 3 to go. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll punt it away for the second time. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. The Saints offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
Call it a pickup of 7, and it'll make it second down. Operating from the 27 now. Here's 2nd and 3. 2nd and 3. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up 3rd. On 3rd and 2, Shaw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2, as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. Now a 1st down carry. It's Kamara. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Now flags will come in. And I think this is against the Saints up front. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back 5. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. 2nd down and long. Following the penalty, it's Kamara. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on 3rd and long. So we've reached halftime in a low-scoring affair, just a pair of field goals. 3-3 is our score. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
All right, Brandon, thank you very much. More from you two in a minute, but first, let's take a spin around the NFL and see what's going on here in week number 10. We'll begin up at legendary Lambeau Field in Green Bay, and those two are tied up as they play the second quarter. From there, it's off to Chicago. Check on the Bears at home at Soldier Field. And they trail the visiting Denver Broncos in that one. The Broncos looking to sew that one up, and they look to be in pretty good shape. Finally, we head to the shores of Lake Erie. See what's going on with the Cleveland Browns. And that one all even as they play the visiting Texans. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been as tight as we expected. All tied through 1 half of play. For the call of the second half, let's get it back to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Second half ready to roll. 2 field goals, the combined output in half number 1.
Come on,
could be first touchdown wins. Out come the Cowboys now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter 3.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. The run there on 1st down gets him 1 yard to the 26. Just 1 yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up 2nd and 9. The last play got just 1 yard. Here's 2nd and 9 from the 26. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Sharp. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher 3rd down looming.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the 3rd quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
from the shotgun. It's Prescott. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Sharp. And he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll come on to kick this one away. It's taken to the 26. Just a net of 34 there following a punt of 44 yards. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. Now the attention turns to the Saints offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. Their defense did its job, yielded no points. Now it's the offense's turn.
And how much fun is that when you set things up to start a half and you just tell you guys, hey, if you can shut them down, get it back for our offense, we can roll. And they played out perfectly. Now, can the offense do what they wanted to do at the half, which is find those weaknesses and now attack them and score some points.
And break this tie. Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves them needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine. To throw on third down, Shaw. Well, the two men come together, and it's incomplete. Excellent work defensively, brings up fourth down.
Now, he's been a busy man out of the backfield. They've looked his way quite a bit so far in this game.
Nice job there defensively, though, adjusting, because a couple of his earlier catches, he was wide open. Not that time.
You mentioned the key word, adjustment. A better cover man on him now in space.
Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because three straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two. Play fake. Here's Prescott. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Cameron Jordan, he's the culprit, and that is now his 13th sack of the season as his great year continues.
We are seeing two really confident defenses imposing their will on these offenses in this game.
Yeah, absolutely, going toe for toe. Just curious if one of these offenses can wake up a little bit.
Is there any way they can find something that can pop, something big to knock them back on their heels?
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Throwing, Prescott, and almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's fourth down.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter, standing right on his own 5-yard line. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. And a fair catch called for and made just inside the 35-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. Now the Saints offense, they get ready to go back to work here. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Operating from the gun, Shaw, it's caught, Smith, and they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. The Saints first down there on a gain of 11. Throwing on first down, Shaw. And This one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down to the hands of the wrong team.
And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. A gain of 3, second down. They'll keep it on the ground. Sharp. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Now it's a bootleg with Prescott. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. They come out here in the eye. Might we see our first touchdown of the game? Here's first and goal. Now Prescott. And this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown. A 1-yard touchdown reception. And the Cowboys have taken the lead. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Extra point attempt here still to come. And it is up. And it's good. That'll make our score 10-3 now. Just a 4-play drive that time. And it's capped off for the Cowboys touchdown. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And now running right through him. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Now out comes their leader and the captain of this offense back onto the field. And he has not really been able to have a lot of comfort back there in the pocket. Pressure's been coming at him a lot, hasn't it?
And they've got to figure out how to tamp down that pressure. How do they decrease it? Is it getting rid of the football quicker? You know, shorter drops? Maybe they do something different with their pass blocking and their protection schemes. Maybe you meet them on the line of scrimmage instead of retreating to try and protect your quarterback. They've got to figure something out, though, because you cannot let your guy get hit that much, not if you intend to win.
I know they'd like to erase that video and those 4 sacks that they've seen so far. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up 3rd down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Chidobe Awuzie with a pick.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Dak and the Cowboys ready for their next possession. He has been consistent, hasn't he? He played well in the first quarter, good second quarter, and now continuing that here in the 3rd.
And that's the word that they're always seeking from the guy taking the snaps, is consistency. Taking care of the ball, making sure it gets to the right people.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Cameron Jordan in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year.
He's NFL sack leader coming into the game, and now that's two more that he's added to his total.
He wants some separation from spot one and two in that sack category. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Now Prescott. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down. Prescott off play action. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46.
That was well defended, and while it was a completion, it resulted in a loss of yardage. It's really, really hard for a running back to think to himself, I probably should have just dropped it and saved the yardage. It goes against the entire training that he's had his whole career.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter. He's been terrific so far. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And there's a work of art right there. Out of bounds at the 2-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. And they will begin with, should we call it, far from ideal starting field position, their own 2-yard line.
So what's your definition of ideal?
The 1-yard line on the other side of the field.
Yes, exactly right. So yes, your definition is apropos in this case.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made. And that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
Well, it wasn't a big strike, but that completion put them in really great range. What do we have now, 4th and inches?
Yeah, it's not more than a half a foot.
You know what I would do here?
You would always go for it.
I'm one of those guys.
Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he's on for the 5th time here today. Not too shabby here. This will skip out of bounds at about the 12-yard line.
Here we go.
Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
They go play action here on first down. He's going to let this one go deep into a double team, and it's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
The Saints coming out now to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They begin on the ground with Kamara. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. Off the bootleg, Shaw. Complete, Smith has it. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. That goes for a gain of 31.
That's a real nice job right there, working the middle of the field, working against those safeties. And you know, partner, if you get your hips turned the wrong way, big plays can result.
And a big play resulted right there. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 25-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. He's got the first down inside the 10. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great effort there. His second touchdown on the season as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
Lutz good on the extra point, and we are even at 10 apiece. Scoring summary, three-play drive, and a long run there in the end to top it off. All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. Now Dak Prescott and the offense heading back onto the field. And it was his interception on the last drive that wound up leading to a game-tying touchdown.
And somehow, you can make this a positive, though. You know why? Game tied now. So you're not protecting a lead. So you're not playing that way. You got to go get the lead again. So maybe it loosens him up a little bit and allows him to go ahead and be a little more free in his play.
Tackle is made by Cameron Jordan. No gain on the play. Throwing on second down. Prescott throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. They had the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and 10. Prescott. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. That one goes for 24 yards. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let them know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
From just shy of midfield, Prescott throwing left side here, and it's complete. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints' 32-yard line.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Switch. And now a carry here for their fullback. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. So both teams trade touchdowns, and the third is worth through three quarters of play. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports.